Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel Witty Scholars. Today I will be discussing step-by-step procedure in finding previous permutation in lexicographic order. If you are new to this channel and missed my previous video related to step-by-step procedure in finding the next permutation, you can find the link in the description given below. So without further delay, let's get started. First of all, let's understand the question. Given the following permutation of letters A to K, what is the previous permutation in lexicographic order? Lexicographic order means dictionary order. So in order to find the previous permutation, I have considered this pattern. So let's get started with step 1. In step 1, we compare the last and last minus 1 element until the condition last minus 1 less than or equal to last fails. So we keep on checking this condition. Once this condition fails, we stop this step. So in the pattern that I have considered, the last minus 1 element is h and the last element is I. Now I check whether the condition h less than or equal to I is it true. The condition is true. So I move on to the next element, g. Now I check whether g is it less than or equal to h. The condition is true. So I move on to the next element, that is e. Again I check whether e is it less than or equal to g. The condition is true. So now I move on to the next element, b. Now I check whether b is it less than or equal to e. The condition is true again. So I move on to the next element, c. Again I check whether c is it less than or equal to b. The condition fails since b is not less than or since c is not less than or equal to b, but instead c is greater than b. So since the condition fails, we stop this step. Now before I move on to the next step, there is one thing that you need to keep in mind. When this condition failed, the last element was b. And the last minus 1 element was c. So with this in mind, moving on to the next step. Step 2, we mark I and P of I. Let me consider the pattern. So from previous step, we know that the condition when it failed, the last element was b. So in this step, P of I will be b. And I is nothing but it is the index value of b. So in order to find that, let me write the index value of each element. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now as you can see, b is at position 6. So I value will be 6. With these two things in mind, let's move on to the next step. In step 3, we compare the elements from p of j plus 1 until the condition p of j plus 1 less than p of I minus 1 fails. So before I can get started with this condition, there are few things that we need to keep in mind. First of all, from previous step, we know I equal to 6, p of I is equal to b. So to make it convenient, let me write the index values. And in order to find j, you can use this condition I minus 1. So since we have this condition, we'll find out j first. So j is equal to I is 6. So 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. And p of j is 5, p of 5 is c. But we don't want p of j, we want p of j plus 1. So since we want j plus 1, and we know j, we can just find out p of j plus 1 by adding 1 to p of j, to j. So 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Hence p of j plus 1 is equal to b. We found p of j plus 1. Now we need to find p of I minus 1. We know p of I as b. So one element minus b is c. But still, to make it more clear, I minus 1 we know I as 6, 6 minus 1 is equal to 5. So P of I minus 1 is P of 5, that is equal to C. So we have P of I minus 1, we have P of J plus 1. So we can check this condition. But before that, one more thing that you need to keep in mind is, whenever this condition is true, you keep incrementing the value of J, but P of I minus 1 will remain constant throughout the step. So let's check whether B is it less than C. The condition is true. Since the condition is true, as I have said, we increment J value. So now J from 5, it will get incremented to 6. As you can see here, J has 5. So now it will get incremented to 6. But we don't want J, we want J plus 1. So 6 plus 1 is 7. So P of J plus 1 is equal to, at 7th position you have E. Now we check whether E is it less than C. The condition fails. Since the condition fails, we stop this step and we move on to the next step. So before that, you have to keep in mind that J value was 6, I value was 6 when this condition failed. With that in mind, moving on to the next step. In step 4, we will be marking P of J, P of I, and J. So let me consider the pattern. I'll write down the index values as well. So from previous step, we know when the condition failed, the I and J value was 6. So P of I and P of J will be B itself. Since P of 6 and P of 6, if you substitute these values, so P of 6 and P of 6 is nothing but B itself. So P of I and P of J will be B itself. With this information, moving on to the next step. Now we swap P of I minus 1 and P of J. Considering the pattern, I'll write down the index values as well. So from previous steps, we know that P of I and P of J were B, and the position was 6. But now we don't want P of I, we want P of I minus 1. Since we know P of I as B, so P of I minus 1 will be C. And from previous step, we know P of J as P of 6, that is B. So now we have these two values, we need to swap these values. So these two values will get swapped, whereas the remaining elements, it will remain in its same position. So you'll have something like this. As you can see, from F to D, the position has not changed for these elements, but B and C got swapped. So previously it was CB and now it got swapped and you get BC. And elements from E to I remains in its same position. So from now on, I'll be using this pattern. We will no longer consider this pattern. We'll only consider this pattern, the one which we got after swapping. So moving on to the next step. In this step, we will be marking I and P of I. Considering the pattern, let me write the index values. The main reason for marking I and P of I again is because the P of I will get updated in this particular step. Previously, we had P of I as B, but in the previous step, I have told that I'll be considering the new pattern. So in the new pattern, the sixth position, we don't have B, but we have C. So the same thing is getting updated here. Now from now on, the P of I value will be C and the I, it will remain the same, 6. With these two information, we'll move on to the next step. So this is the last step. Here, elements from P of I till the end will get reversed, while from the first element in the list till the element before P of I will remain in its same position. So let me take the pattern and explain this. From F till B, it will remain in its same position. From C till I, the elements will get reversed. So after doing this, we'll get something like this. So this is your final result. As you can see, F, J, K, A, D, B remains in its same position. There is no change in the position. Whereas elements C, E, G, H, I got reversed. So now you have, instead of C, you have I. Instead of E, you have H. Instead of G itself. And instead of H, you have E. Instead of I, you have C. And both together will be your final output. Hope this video was helpful. Please do like and share my video. Do subscribe to my channel. Until we meet next time, keep learning. Thank you.